So what do our legal eagles think? Former federal prosecutor Doug Burns and general counsel at the American Civil Rights Union, Ken Klukowski. Gentlemen, great to have both of you with us on this Friday night as we iron out this DACA decision.
Thanks, Shannon.
Doug, let me start with you. I mean, essentially, it sounds like what they're saying is, listen, DHS and this Trump administration didn't put up a good enough argument about why this program should be disbanded. But you know all along what they've said is, it never had the constitutional authority behind President Obama to start it.
Right.
And so why can't this president unwind it?
Well, there's a couple ways to digest this opinion. I mean, on the one hand, you can report somewhat fairly, you know, that this judge is giving a bit of a stinging rebuke on the question of DACA itself. But on the other hand, then I went through the opinion. I mean, this was the judge who back, Shannon, April 25th, gave the government 90 days, making it very clear that if you articulate a solid reason for terminating it, this court will listen to you carefully. They came forward after 90 days, and then this judge says, once again, you've failed to articulate it. But the last paragraph of the opinion is the key. The judge said, this court is not holding that DHS cannot terminate the program. It's holding that you didn't give us a sufficient reason.
Yeah, and they're saying none of this is going to kick in until at least August 23rd, so there can be a chance for appeal. In the meantime, let me read a little bit of the judge's decision. He says, the court simply holds that if DHS wishes to rescind the program or to take any other action for that matter, it must give a rational explanation for its decision. A conclusory assertion that a prior policy is illegal, accompanied by a hodgepodge of illogical or post hoc policy assertions, simply won't do it. Ken, is this their fault for not getting this right?
Well, Shannon, I think this is going to be the travel ban 2.0, and it means that we can't get Brett Kavanaugh on the Supreme Court soon enough. He needs to be confirmed as the new justice because this case may end up there eventually. The reality is that DACA, there are three legal problems with DACA. There's a federal law for how agencies make policy to implement statutes. It's the Administrative Procedure Act.
Right.
When DAPA was created, DAPA is the bigger, later version of DAPA. When both DACA and DAPA were created, it did not go through the APA. Even if you do go through the APA, if a regulation violates another federal statute, it's illegal. Congress determines these immigration issues, and they do it through the Immigration and Nationality Act, the INA. But even all that aside, every president has the duty under Article 2 of the Constitution to take care that the laws be faithfully executed. The Fifth Circuit Appeals Court 3 years ago held that DAPA, the bigger version of DACA, was unconstitutional because it violated the Administrative Procedure Act and it was inconsistent with the Immigration and Nationality Act. The court didn't even reach the constitutional question because they say there are multiple ways that that's unconstitutional. All that went on here is the president and his DHS secretary and his attorney general looked at that Fifth Circuit decision and they said, well, if DAPA is illegal, then DACA is illegal too. If our administration is doing something illegal today, we need to stop it today. And that was their rational explanation. The court should have adopted that explanation.
Yeah, they weren't.
And instead, we have to take this up on appeal now.
Yeah, they weren't very, very big fans of the reasoning in what they received. Our buddy Buck Sexton, who's on the show quite a bit, folks know him. This is what he tweeted today. Why do we even have a president? Apparently, all we need is a handful of left-wing federal judges. Doug?
Well, under separation of powers and working off of Ken's point, he's right. I mean, this is really a congressional matter. The irony of ironies here is the argument is President Obama did not have the authority to put this program in by way of executive order. I personally agree with that. So the irony, though, is that it gets volleyed right back in your face, which is you don't have the authority to discontinue it. And it's very ironic, in my opinion.
Okay, I want to read a little bit of this new report from the U.S. Citizenship and Immigration Services. They said this in looking into DACA. They said, the truth is, we led those with criminal arrests for sexually assaulting a minor, kidnapping, human trafficking, child pornography, or even murder be provided protection from removal under DACA. Until that can be repealed, this criminality data only reinforces the need for its continued review and scrutiny, which was imposed unilaterally by the Obama administration in circumventing Congress. Ken, getting to Doug's point there about this argument, what it always turns back to.
Yeah, that's exactly right. As I said several years ago, the courts held, okay, this violates the Administrative Procedure Act. Even if it didn't, it still violates Congress's law, the Immigration and Nationality Act. And there were those that hinted that even if all that were satisfied, it would still violate the president's duty under the Take Care Clause of the Constitution to carry out the law as Congress makes it. So the fact that President Trump looked at this and his cabinet looked at it and said, God, guys, Obama's program is illegal. We need to stop it now. It turns everything on its head. The judge has it completely upside down to say that if a prior administration is breaking the law, that a new president cannot immediately stop it. Hmm. And I think that's what the courts will say on appeal at the Supreme Court, if needs be, which is why we need Brett Kavanaugh.
Well,
there.
Yeah, and just to remind everyone, Justice Kennedy is officially retired and stepped down. So we have 8 justices right now, and that impacts everything that goes up to the court. We're going to talk about another emergency filing tonight. In the meantime, on DACA, Doug and Ken, thank you both very much.
Thanks, Shannon. God bless.